Thank you, Councillor. Councillor, I note what the Taoiseach said to Deputy Adams about the achievements in Europe last week, and I think it would be appropriate if someone from this side of the House congratulated the government on a seriously. Thank you. Don't get excited. On a seriously successful diplomatic mission. I think it's right that we should do that, and I think it's also right that we should acknowledge the fact that that was put into the communique by the other parties.
Thank you. Deputy Rusty.
I think Taoiseach, what the Taoiseach called a seismic shift certainly happened in Europe last week. Not necessarily on the banking question, but what was welcome was that there appears to have been a change in the balance of power in Europe because of an ambush of Mrs. Merkel by France, Italy and Spain late in the night. And I hope, Taoiseach, that you were part of that ambush. I don't expect you to take the credit for it, but I think that you were part of that particular mission to achieve the end of German Frank leadership and domination of Europe, and I welcome that. But I'd like to ask you a question about the headline change which was made. And the headline change, which is very dramatic, which was obviously that there was a breakthrough on the difference between the distinction between the sovereign and the banking debt. What is important, though, to address, I think, is this. What difference does getting that monkey, that banking monkey off our back, make to the ordinary citizens of Ireland? In other words, the Minister for Finance has already said that it'll make no difference in the next budget. Will it make any difference? Is there any comfort in this great diplomatic triumph, which it is, for the average person on the street, for the small businessman about whom Deputy Martin was talking about, for the unemployed about for whom Gerry Adams was speaking? And whereas you can talk about the projects and the project bonds, which are part of a different package, can you explain to us how this big difference, this big separation of the sovereign and the banking debt will make a difference to the people who are suffering under the austerity at the moment?
Thank you for your comments, Deputy Ross. This was good news for people in the sense that those who spoke about the European Union and hope for people actually got a response from the European Council meeting last week. It's not a case of anybody looking for any credit here, because I actually give great credit to the Irish people for their decision on the referendum, which was accepted and understood by all of the leaders of the 27, not just the 17, and that was, if you like, credit in the bank, to use a pun, for use at an opportune time. The decision made by the Council through the process of the Jobs and Growth Agenda, which did crystallise around the election of President Hollande, the discussions on the EMU, the discussions arising from the conclusion of the Presidency of Denmark, set out a strategy and a plan which offers consistency for people. The discussion that took place in respect of this decision, which will lead to a permanent supervisory responsibility for the European Central Bank, was certainly brought into light by the difficulties that a number of the bigger economies in Europe actually have. The Minister for Finance is right, Deputy Ross, in the sense that for this particular budget for 2013, this decision will not make an appreciable difference in their in their contribution on a week-to-week basis. We still have to deal with our public financial problem here at home. But clearly, and the opportunity for impact beneficially for future budgets is very clear. And I think it's also accepted that the markets are now factoring in their analysis of the euro and the yields for different countries, what this actually means. I note that the NTMA are to hold an auction for short-term money on Thursday, which will be an indication in its own way, if you like, while we're in a programme of a toe in the water, as it were. But clearly, the fact that the Troika are here again, I think, for their seventh analysis now, and where Ireland is again expected to measure up, is all part of the acceptance of this country being a serious player about a serious problem. And clearly, in the conclusions of the council meeting, the fact that Ireland was actually named specifically in the context of equality of treatment, as I said, breaks and reverses what applied about what I spoke last week, where the principle of European direction without acceptance of European liability applied in the past, where this country and our people, our communities, our taxpayers, our workers, our families were required as a consequence of that decision to shoulder the entire burden. So for the future, not for this forthcoming budget, but for the future, this brings clarity, brings a degree of certainty, hopefully that the economies of Europe can start to grow, that for an exporting nation like us that means more jobs, but also that Europe as a unit will be able to continue to buy on the global market, which impacts on the global economy. So not for this budget, but certainly for the future, the negotiations that will now be entered into are important. And people say to me, well, you know, what figure are you talking about? I don't have any bottom line here, Deputy Ross. What I have is a top line. And the top line is the maximum benefit and the best result for our people and for our country. And all that process starts next Monday with the ECOFIN ministers, where Ireland will be represented by the Minister for Finance.
Thank you, Deputy Ross.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Can I take it from that although there won't be any effects in this budget, there will be tangible effects in the next budget and the budget afterwards? And if that's the case, perhaps you could tell us where you're going to target those particular benefits and what area of the economy will take a priority in the benefits which are going to come from this particular separation of the banks and the sovereign debt. And secondly, you didn't address the issue which I raised about the change of the balance of power in Europe. That is vitally important. And I wonder, could you comment on the fact that there was undoubtedly a change when France basically confronted Germany, eyeballed Mrs. Merkel, and won? And could you tell us what part you played and Ireland played in that particular new division of power in Europe?
Well, sure. I think it's a wonderful thing to observe the commentators who comment and the speculation that goes on. Clearly, those who might have had a very different view a number of weeks ago, a number of months ago, now reflect because of the decision that was made by the European Council. I note that Colin McCarthy said, this is not a diplomatic win, it's a financial win. And in that, I agree with him. Yes, there's a different reflection around the table, Deputy Ross. And I think the fact that President Hollande made it perfectly clear before his election that if elected, he would require a growth agenda. But the process of a European Council meeting is that nothing is agreed until all is agreed. And those segments of that discussion took place between 2:30 and 5 a.m. the following morning. And of course, the concluding hours of that meeting were taken up with the Eurozone, the 17 who share the same currency. From that perspective, I have to say that the interest and understanding of France in what Ireland has done here, both in terms of its decisions that were made in the context of our people having given a very clear verdict on the fiscal stability referendum, speaks for itself. And in my conversations with President Hollande, both by telephone from government buildings and at the meetings that we have attended, France has expressed a genuine interest in seeing this country making its way steadily through difficult economic circumstances to be the first to emerge from the bailout programme. I would say to you, as somebody who has genuine interest in all of this, what we're at here is having opened a door of opportunity and potential, is to use that now in the best interest of our people and our country and our economy. Because I'm not interested, frankly, in attempted point scoring. I'm not interested in those who say you should be out here looking for credit for this. The people know. Psychologically, this has been an important boost for Ireland. Also for Portugal, for Spain, obviously, and for Italy. And we should build on these opportunities, because a lot of the information in respect of the Troika, the assessment of our banks, has already been put in there. Ministers are dealing with the Troika this week, and Minister Noonan starts the process of making arrangements to implement this decision next Monday. I hope that can follow through as quickly as possible, though the logistics, I think, are going to be quite detailed. But hopefully before the end of the year, that there'll be clarity and decisiveness brought to the decision of the European Council. So for any member of the House here who genuinely has a constructive suggestion to make about how we build on this to reduce the burden on our families, our communities, our workers, our taxpayers, we'd be very interested in hearing that. Government have a number of options open to it, Deputy Ross, and that process will start on Monday. They'll all feed into the system. And for me, the answer is the best result is the top line. The most and the maximum result we can get for our country and for our people. I'm sure you want to share that yourself.
Thank you. That completes Leader's questions for today.